Bro, they were armed this whole time and he was fine. Damn! Why would there be a rose in the warehouse? What is up, guys? It's John here, aka Bruce Lee, and Avery is back. We're gonna do another breakdown for y'all with Transporter 3, Jason Statham, supposedly the best fight scene. I actually don't know what happened to the scene. Avery, can you remind me what happened to the scene?
So he's surrounded by like tons of guys. There's a girl watching. She's very impressed with his boobs.
Wait, we're watching a fight scene, right? This isn't like Pornhub.
Yeah, it's a fight scene from.
Okay, sick.
No, it's from no. It's gonna be cool. A lot of front kicks, a lot of side kicks.
All right, well, we're gonna give you guys a breakdown and give it a rating on 1 out of 10 based on 2 criteria: how realistic we think it is and how entertaining it is, since that's really the main goal of the movie. Let's get started. Play. So it's a little bit different with when they have pipes and weapons, right? Like, you have to fight a little differently, I think. Actually, that one guy's a wrench. Front kick, side kick,
elbow.
Boom. Did he have elbow to the body? So that he had landed an elbow to the body, I think, right here. Do you think it actually like stuns the guy that much? Because the guy's literally like,
I don't know. I don't know if you would do this, like, oh, like that. And then, like, right here, he's going to grab behind his neck and he's going to flip him over his shoulder.
Yeah. I mean, the elbow to the body is more karate style. Do you think this is pretty realistic?
I think it could happen. I just think it's very unlikely to go in this order of, like, him elbowing and then he comes down and he grabs behind the head and then flips him over.
Yeah. I think I have my doubts as well. It looks cool, though. Especially like when you have time to front kick another person. A lot of spinning side kicks.
See that? You see how he swept the leg underneath?
Yeah, I like that. Cool. I Ip Man does that. Let's watch that again. He grabs underneath the knee and flips the guy. Is that work?
I think it would.
Yeah?
I think it would work. I think you just have to have really good timing.
Yeah.
And well, like a really, really good baseball bat swing with your arm.
That's true. But you know what? He also had the momentum from this other spin kick to help him carry through that. So when you have like that much time to spin, I think it could happen. I don't even know what's happening there.
Yeah, he's got control of him and this kind of weird control with his tricep, like his clothing and his tricep kind of.
Do you think someone would be... Do you think he'd be stuck? Actually, he could be stuck like that because he's hyperextending the shoulder from the front, right? Bam. Let's see this. Because I like, for me, I'd just be like, if I was the guy that's being held, I wouldn't just like sit there being like, uh-oh,
yeah.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, like I wouldn't be sitting there. Like right now he could be escaping.
Yeah, he could be struggling or something, right?
That's legit right there, rewind.
Yeah.
So he's gonna lock his arm within his arms, and it's called the Americana, which you would see in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. And this is legit. You can use this to disarm somebody. So he's blocking the attack.
Here's the slow-mo. He blocks. Okay, that's the position you're talking about. So basically, he's put his arm over the guy's like elbow and is pressuring his forearm to kind of hyperextend him the wrong way.
It's actually not quite exactly how you would do it in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, but it's the same submission kind of thing where you're hyperextending the shoulder this way.
That's cool. That's cool. So if someone's actually attacking you with, like, in this case, a wrench or a pipe or something like that, you can absolutely disarm them with this, you said.
I think it could work. Yeah. I mean, just like anything, it's only going to work if you do it properly. It's the right circumstance. So.
Yeah. I mean, he's grabbed the arm and he's pressured the wrist to have him lose the grip and drop the weapon. So, like, for me, that does seem realistic if you can execute it. And of course, they did it faster in this choreography, but I think in principle, it absolutely does work.
And this guy is coming up behind him, so let's see what happens here.
Bang.
Elbow.
Elbows behind.
Takes off his shirt, kicks him in the nuts. That's cool.
That's like an execution, bro. That's
pretty cool. Flips him over his back. Elbow, escape.
So you see, actually, one more other thing is, like, when he elbows, like, the gut here, and he lets go completely, I still don't know if, like, a backward elbow with, like, not much pivot, not much, like, drive into it, like, you're only using really, like, your shoulder blade to pull back, and then someone's like, oh, Like, I don't know, that's a little bit of a stretch for me is the only thing. But when you're fighting, like, in when you have a choreography with 14 guys, you need quick stuff, I guess.
So now he's using his tie, I think. He was using his tie to his clothing to fight here.
Yeah, just tie up the arms, literally. I don't know why he has to get undressed necessarily, but I guess his shirt was a weapon there too.
She's like, ooh. I like.
Uh-oh.
Grab the hammer.
That's so funny to me that, like, these guys had, like, pipes, wrenches that were, like, 3 feet long. The guy grabs, like, a 1 foot hammer. Then all of a sudden she's like, uh-oh. I'm like, bro, they were armed this whole time and he was fine.
Yeah, like, now it's a problem.
Now it's a problem. Oh, here we go. I feel like a fire extinguisher would be a good weapon here.
I like how he's using, like, his surroundings.
He just grabbed the other guy's belt and whipped him.
Dude, watch. See that? Rewind that. That was hilarious. So, like, he whips the belt around the guy's ankle. It wraps around his ankle. And then he pulls it out and takes his feet out from underneath. So I actually did that once to, I was teaching a karate class and I was like swinging my belt around and having the kids jump over the belt. And there was one little girl like didn't jump over the belt in time. And I like wrapped my belt around her legs like multiple times and then it pulled it and like by accident, I didn't do it on purpose. That was so funny. Like the exact same thing that happened there.
Dude, that sounds like karate version of the Fall Guys game.
I think it could work. I think it could work, is my point.
I think so too. Like, because I've seen a lot of movies, like even like Spartacus and stuff like that, people are getting like the whip like locked into place. So with the belt, obviously, it works decent, but like back in the day, like some of the whips had like actual like grips or like knobs on them, and when that locked into place, you'd actually like pull someone on their forearm or their leg, exactly like that. And those are movies as well, so I don't know 100%, but to me it seems in principle that it would work.
In principle, yeah. Theoretically.
Oh, he finally gets a weapon! There you go. He has like a metal bow staff almost. Oh! That's damn! Bad. What's that, Andre the Giant?
And that scene, pause it, he said, are you the smart guy? And then he said, no, I'm the big guy.
That's literally like out of like, this feels like out of the Princess Bride. I still can't tell how big this guy is, to be honest.
He's way taller than
huge.
So nothing's working. He's like, what the fuck am I gonna do?
Oh, that's cool. That's actually, I really like that that leg grab into a spin.
Yeah. Check out Kung Lee and his old fights. Check out his highlights. He does that move all the time.
Yeah, he goes into a roll to take him down, right? But actually, this move, I remember you showing it to me that one day. But I like this, like, brace, grab, and spin. I actually learned this move differently in Muay Thai. You don't slam them into barrels, but it absolutely works, which is cool. That was smart. Get the high ground a little bit. It's good someone's that much taller.
Yeah.
Oh. Ooh. Damn.
Lucky.
He got so lucky with that. That'd be terrifying to have like a 7 foot dude just like.
Check this out. Now they're the same size.
No more height advantage.
Like left hook, right hook.
I'd say that's pretty realistic too, because when I'm gonna call this guy Andre because I don't know his actual name. When Andre the Giant here is shorter and it takes away that height advantage, that's a big factor. But the other thing is the fact that he can't plant his feet or move his feet properly. It does make it harder to like take punches, right? Like before, absolutely. When he was taking punches, he's kind of like he had his foundation down and nothing was working. But now that he can't really be in control of his balance and his feet, he's kind of now all of a sudden these punches and kicks are working. Because he can't move, can't brace.
Here comes the finisher.
Oh. Damn. They could have made that more gory. Because I think that actually would have blew up his skull. Oh, of course there's a rose. Why would there be a rose in the warehouse?
Before Vendetta.
All right, guys, that was Transporter 3, where Jason Statham fights a bunch of dudes with wrenches in a warehouse, and then he fights the big one, aka Andre the Giant. What did you think of that so far, Avery? Do you think it was realistic?
I thought, like, for the most part, it actually was pretty realistic. The only thing I don't think was super realistic is how, you know, with how much ease he could handle all these opponents.
Yeah.
I don't know if a lot of the clothes, when he was using his own clothing for
as defense, a weapon.
As a weapon. I don't know. I'm not, like, super trained in using my own clothing as a weapon, so I don't know to what degree that stuff is realistic, but I'd say like for the most part, like his attack, his strikes, like his front kicks, his side kicks, his spinning kicks, his, like, the grappling I was questionable, so like that's really the only thing was his grappling and like the using of clothing.
Yeah, because he tied up people's, like, wrists and arms and, like, dragged them this way and that way, or, like, dragged the guy with the neck over. I think the neck one was pretty realistic. Like, if someone has, like, kind of like a guillotine almost around you with just, like, fabric and pulls you down, I think you will go with them. Because, like, naturally, like, you can steer people's bodies with the neck. But, like, when we started tying up people's hands with his shirt, like, bang, and, like, drove him this way and drove him that way. I think that really only works if you've told the stunt guy to be like, hey, when I get your hand, be fucking limp. Like, let me move you, because anyone who's like in stance, you know, they're not gonna let you just like drag them all around. They're gonna pull back. And I think when even one, or in this case, he tied up I think two hands from two different people at once. I'm like, well, you know, if two people are holding against you in that position, I think they're gonna pull you. You're not gonna pull them. So that was a little questionable, but I agree with the front kicks and the side kicks especially, and even his punches on the big one there, where he's like bang bang, like those hooks, like. From a kickboxing or, you know, whatever, any traditional martial art perspective, I think those kicks were really, really good. So I'll give him that. But I agree, the grappling was a bit sus. And the other thing that was a little sus that for me, and I say this all the time where in fight scenes where one dude fights like a bunch of different guys, that like if I was in the situation of like the 7 guys or the 10 guys, I would like give like one guy a look, and we'd come at the same time. And if you do that, fighting a different angle, like from three different perspectives, I think no matter what, like no matter how good of a martial artist you are, I think you're gonna go down or get taken down. And after that, like, you know, 10 guys are pummeling you. So I think they kind of, was it out of honor or just choreography that they kind of fought him like one at a time is my only other like question there, right? Like if it was like a true life or death situation, like I'm not gonna be like, hey, Avery, you go. Ah, shit. Okay, let's go. Okay, I'll go. And I'm like, all right, like, you know, Tom, yeah. Dick, Harry, you go, right? So that's the other thing that's a little sus, but for dealing with multiple people, I think that was pretty cool.
It seemed like every time somebody would come up behind him, he would just throw an elbow.
Yeah, that's also another sus thing. I don't know. I love backward elbows, but I think the driving force of when I do a spinning elbow is I step in, I spin pretty much 180 to get the driving force of the elbow. It's not just my arm going like this. So to have like the stopping power of just this, I don't know works, especially to the body. Because in Muay Thai, I've never really thrown an elbow purposely to the body. You know what I mean? So a few things that were sus, but yeah. Comment below what you guys thought. We're going to give our ratings here. I'll let Avery go first. 1 out of 10, how realistic did you think it was?
I'll give it a 7.5.
Oh, that's pretty high. That's higher than I was going to say. Damn it. I was going to give it... So I don't want to say higher, but I won't. I'm going to give it like a 5 out of 10. And I think that, so it's like for me, it's like 50-50, right? Because like for me, the striking was all good. But everything that wasn't the striking, like the strategy and the grappling, that for me was a little unbelievable. So, you know, maybe I should give it a 6. I don't know. That was a controversial one for me. Comment below what you guys thought. But we're going to give it our rating on entertainment factor, since that's the real purpose of the movie, is to watch it and have fun. Avery, what are you going to give it?
So, I love Jason Statham. And the big one at the end, I really enjoyed that scene. How, like, he was using the strategy of making himself the same height by either you know, going up to a higher object, or in the end making him smaller by him like falling through the floor, basically
losing his ground, right?
I thought it was kind of comical as well.
Yeah, it's kind of funny.
Him using his clothing, I think, was really cool and entertaining.
Yeah, it's almost like his attempt of like pulling a Jackie Chan, in my opinion, you know what I mean? So which that was still pretty cool. And also excuse to get like naked for the girl.
So I would give it a 9 out of 10, just because Jackie Chan was 10 out of 10. I don't think he was as entertaining as Jackie Chan was.
That's a good point. I think Jackie Chan is definitely unique. Like, people have been trying to replicate Jackie Chan forever of, like, using, like, objects around you and your surroundings around you in a comical way. And he did a pretty good job here, but still no Jackie Chan. I'm going to give it a 9 out of 10 as well. And for me, the only point I couldn't give it a 10 is the same thing I say, like, almost all my videos. Of like, if I don't fully grasp it, it's, like, pretty close to realistic. Like, for me, I just can't give it a... Like, the martial artist in me can't just... He's just like, dude, the elbow freaking stopped the guy. Like, I just can't get over it. I thought it was pretty fun, though, man. Even before the big one, like, the badassery of fighting that many guys who were armed using like front kicks and side kicks and like quick reflex, like I think that's so cool. And like, you know, watching that as a layman, I think that makes you want to get into martial arts, which I absolutely love, because especially when it's realistic, you know what I mean?
Right.
So obviously, you know, I gave it a 5, but still, like, there's a lot of realistic stuff about it.
Yeah, honestly, 7.5 might even be too high of a score for the realism, but I think generally speaking, 75% of what he did in the scene could work. So
yeah, I think Jason Statham is like a pretty legit martial artist, right? And actually, what I like about Jason Statham a lot is that he's not like, and there's nothing against this guy, but like, he's not like The Rock or like Chris Evans, right? Like, there's few martial artists who are big who look exactly like Chris Evans, like super, super jacked, or like The Rock, you know, because it kind of gets in the way. Jason Statham is like kind of like more ripped, lean body, that's agile and athletic. That for me is what a martial artist looks like, more so than like some of the other martial artists I've seen that are almost like too swole. So just like another like
badass there.
Yeah, he's badass on his own. He doesn't need to have like 33-inch biceps to be badass. You know what I mean? It's his face, it's his confidence, it's his demeanor. That's what makes him, that's a big part of martial arts as well, is your own confidence, right? So it's not about looking the part, it's about like moving the part almost. And Jason Statham actually absolutely for me moves the part. So I really like him. We're gonna leave it there, you guys. So I hope you enjoyed that. But again, please leave a comment of other videos you'd like us to review. What did you think, right? Did all of that seem realistic? Is there some things that we missed maybe? Let us know, because we want to hear all about it. We're gonna see you next time. We got Avery here. Thank you again, bro.
Thank you.
And Bruce Lee's gonna sign off. See you guys next time. Oh, and like, comment, subscribe.